best things about working with John for so long was seeing him change the things that he used to complain about. Given his unwavering sense of urbanism, there were always a lot of things to complain about, and it was never easy to change any of them. Starting out in Milwaukee, there was a drive-thru McDonald's in a historic district with a drive-thru that the city zoning actually permitted. That was really the instigation for John to work with the council to completely revamp and urbanize that zoning. And then there was this freeway, which had obliterated a beautiful part of Milwaukee's downtown riverfront. John got it torn down, replaced with a lift bridge, streets and blocks, new housing followed, as did a new hotel and a new corporate headquarters. There was the LEED system that was giving awards to buildings in unsustainable contexts. Now, thanks to John's help and help from CNU and its allies and partners, LEED is giving platinum awards to neighborhoods like this one. If you saw one of John's slideshows, you heard about how Mima Magna has one of the shortest and most convenient commutes possible from her apartment upstairs behind me to her restaurant below. Changing the federal underwriting rules to make these kinds of projects so rare will really prevent these kinds of projects is one of the hardest changes of all. But CNU stuck with it and got FHA and Fannie Mae to make progress on changing these rules.
His willingness to spend his political capital on things that weren't always easy, but they were right for the city. They made better design, they made better urbanism in Milwaukee.
John Norquist has to have been one of the funniest mayors that ever existed.
At first you might not be able to tell that John has a really wry sense of humor, because his delivery is, it comes as a surprise.
All the times where he walks out of the office and comes up behind me at my desk with one of his corny jokes, that a punchline that they're really funny and make no sense, but those are really the best.
He's not just into urbanism, he's into people. And it is because of him I am now an urbanist.
He's Mr. Elbows. I play basketball with him on Saturdays. He's a lot taller than I am, so when he throws an elbow, it's usually at my chin.
I've been with the CNU from the very beginning, and when John took over as president, CEO, it was a dark day. It wasn't clear at all that the CNU would survive financially. And John did an incredible job.
His calm and steady demeanor throughout that entire couple of years was really remarkable. I know I went home stressed, you know, several times, and he was really deliberate in his decisions and thoughtful, and was able to keep the rest of us on track.
John clearly has a passion for highway teardowns and has been uniquely effective in North America in getting them torn down.
I think in the early days a lot of people did not understand why John thought that this was an issue that needed to be pushed by CNU. And in fact, I think I was one of the doubters. I didn't quite see this as a winning issue for CNU. But over time, John, through persistence and through inspirational leadership, has got a lot of us on board with the idea of the importance of an organization like CNU pushing this issue and making it part of its core being. And I think it's really changed the direction of CNU for the good. It's made us a much broader organization and actually a more relevant organization.
You know, he's taught me so much over the last 10 years of being CEO of Urbanism, and really provided a legacy for how CNU can affect large change in the building and removal of infrastructure.
He believed in the long-term value of cities, and that you didn't need to throw money at things, and that there was inherent value, that he, as a manager, and I was his client one time in Milwaukee, I taught his staff how to manage and run the city in a way that created wealth for the citizens.
John Norquist's instinctive and deep intellectual understanding of what makes cities work, what makes cities valuable and beautiful and financially sound, I think make him one of the most influential and important thought leaders of our time.
Basically, we're saving the world here, but we're doing it without having to go into caves. We're actually saving the world by making life better.